Hey, welcome to Explosions and Rainbows. My name is Lee Americoon. I also go by Gizmosan on Twitter and on YouTube. And I've done tutorials before. I did a fire tutorial and some destruction tutorials. And I thought maybe it'd be a good time to get back into doing tutorials again and show my process, how I create visual effects in games. And there was a I'm playing Skyrim right now, and there's this awesome effect. I have it right here, and I was thinking we would make something like this. It's pretty easy to do. There's lots of elements to it, but I thought it'd be kind of fun as a first tutorial for my website to show how you go about making something like this. We'll be using UDK. I've already built the level ready to go, as you can see here. So it's all ready to go, and the file is included on the website. So let's get started. So I want to take a look at this video that I captured from Skyrim, and as you can see here, there's some tendrils that are coming off, and we'll be making those using planes in 3D Studio Max, and we'll probably be putting like a fall off to it. We'll do that in the texture too. We'll also be using some material tricks as well. In the center here, they've got these beams of light, and they're kind of spreading out, and we can do that using either meshes or with a texture. I'll be showing how to create both of those. Also, the inner ring right here, it looks like it's also a texture that's rotating and panning it quickly at high velocity. Also, there's a center light in the middle. That might be another texture. I think in this game it was a creature, so what we could probably do is make our own, like grab a player model from UDK and maybe make it glow, or perhaps have a ball of light we could do in Max or something like that. I don't know. I when I'm making these things, I tend to go on a whim and just kind of see like how it generally flows. That's how I do it at work, is I generally start with an idea and then build upon it. So, alright, so this is what we're going to do. So first of all, let's take a look at our scene that I made earlier. Okay. And as you can see, it's pretty basic. It's just a castle and some rocks and a terrain. And get rid of that. Okay. And there's nothing much to it. I didn't put a ceiling on it. You could put a ceiling on it if you'd like, but I didn't bother doing that. Just wanted to show how to do the wood. So anyway, so if you think about it, right about here is going to be the ball, or the beam of light. And actually in UDK, if you go to your content browser and go up to engine under content, you can go under meshes, and if you scroll down, you should see a little ball right here. You can just drag that over, and we could use that as our like focal point of where we're going to put our effect. So now see right here, it's snapping, and right now my snap is set to 128. So if you hit the bracket next to P, you can drop that down to 8, and you can fine tune move it. So let's say, for example, that's going to be where the ball of light is going to be coming from, right about there. Okay, so now I'm going to switch over to Max, and we're going to build the initial piece in Max. Okay, so here we are inside of Max. You could use Maya or any other 3D software package. I am only using Max because this is what I'm most familiar with. But like I said, you could use any other package you want. So what I'm generally going to do is, so look at our scene again, and so we got the ball up there. So let's roughly put a, so right now let's use a plane. So I'm going to hit make a plane. And I'm going to put it in the center, like that. So that's roughly where the ball of light's going to be. If you want to, you could put a ball in the middle, so I'll do that as well. So put a little ball in the middle. Okay. And we're not going to export that because it's probably really high. Yep. Okay. So, okay, so we want the tendrils to be coming out of it. So we're going to go ahead and make a spline. And I'll go from the top. adjust the vertexes a little bit so there's a little more. It's coming out. Now, you don't have to do it this way. This is just one way of doing it. You have better ways of making this than do that. This is just the way that I'm going to do it for this tutorial. So, let's say for example, it goes up to there. And maybe that bends down. Let's see. Yeah, that's good. Okay. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to, let's see, I probably want to duplicate it, so I'll have it come down like there. Now, what I could have done instead is I could have done extrude on that, but what I like to do, this is something I learned at work, is if you select the line and you hit attach, so it becomes, they become together, joined together. And if you go up to cross section, it actually draws the surface in between it. Oops. And then you could also go to surface, and then that draws the surface on there. Now you could also have done extrude, but what is nice is though, is that if you go to now the vertex again, and you pull them in. Like so, and go back to the top, it automatically updates. So that way we could have them like come together at the ends, or we could move them around a little bit more so we're not exactly focused on what it looks like. So maybe this part comes out a little more, and then maybe this part right here, that will come out a little more, and maybe that'll come down maybe a little bit. And to the left, maybe that goes up a little bit. Like that, and back to surface. Maybe something like that. Maybe let's see. What might be move there's a little more. So what's nice about that technique is like I said, I didn't know to do this. In I usually do this the select the line and extrude, but this is something I learned from my lead at my current job, and it works out a lot good because it works great for making weapon trails, which is what I. Make quite a bit. So let's see, that's pretty good. I like that. Be a little out, a little more, maybe put down these. Okay. So now what you can do is we can, you go up to Edit Poly, and it puts all the additional verts and edges on there. Now, if you're doing it for low poly, general, you can always go back to surface, and you can actually hit the where it says steps, you can drop it down. So it's nothing, and then you could smooth it later, and then do it like so. What I do at work, for example, is I drop it down to like 3 because we have to do fairly low poly, and then I go back to edge and I select edges, hit loop, and then I hit shift back, control delete, and then I've got like a it's much easier, it's much a little more low poly, but still remains the shape. But since we're doing it Unreal, Unreal just seems to chew through polys, so we don't really need to do that. Now let's see. Sorry about that. Okay, so we would have to unwrap it. So actually, you know what? Let's go ahead and do that, and then I can unwrap it easier. So go to UV unwrap edit. Now, there's this wonderful plugin that we have at work that is free for Macs that will UV unwrap it really quickly. So let me pause this real quick, and we'll come back, and I'll go get it, and then I'll show you where I got it from. Okay, we're back, and I just want to show you where I got that plugin from. It's called UV Straightener. It's on ScriptSpot, it's called. Just do a Google search for UV Straightener. It's really, let me download it real quick and show you what it does. It's really good. What you can do is you just grab this script and drop it into the UV. You'd go to, drop it up here. Okay, and then you go back to UVW unwrap. And you'll see it says mapping and it says straighten UV strip. So what I can do now is select the faces. Go to mapping, straighten, normalize. And there we go. It's already all straightened out. So pretty awesome script for doing this kind of stuff. So okay, so that is going to be the back, and this is going to be the front. Okay, so what I want to do now is make sure this is in the one-to-one space, because this is going to be controlling what the texture looks like. So let's see, that's good for now. Alright, so we could collapse it. Okay. Now we're going to open up Photoshop. Okay, so as you can see here, these it's like a fade off right here, and it's kind of scrolling into the middle. So in Photoshop, we're going to make a gradient so the edges of the mesh don't show up, so it doesn't have like a hard edge to it. We're also mess around, make some textures for it to flow along the edges with. So moving over to Photoshop. So we're going to go to File, New, and do 512 by 512. And we're going to put a black texture on it. So Shift F5. And go to Gradient. And we want the edges to be black and the internal in the middle to be white. So add a piece there, change that color to black, make that white, make that black with some fall off in the middle, and then we're just gonna drag this across like that. Now we're going to have a hard edge on the top, see right on the top. So what I like to do also is grab our brush, and we'll get like a 60, make a little bigger, and then using the black, just kind of black off the top and the bottom, so it doesn't have such a hard edge to it when you bring it in, we bring it to Unreal. So what I do is save as. And we're gonna go where you stored it. So it might be UDK, the newest version in the game, in the content. And I'm gonna make a new folder and call this Skyrim. Call it Skyrim Aura. And I'm saving this as a Targa. And call it, we'll just call this gradient tendril. and it's 24 bit. So a 32 bit would have an alpha. We're just gonna do 24 bit for the texture. And okay, so another. So we'll go back to max, and I'll show you what it looks like in max. So in max, we're just gonna bring up the material editor, and set diffuse bitmap. And go back to where we were. So I'm gonna apply it to the texture so you can see it. So there you see. So on the outskirts, it's gonna be completely transparent. And then it's going to kind of flow its way in and come down and come into there and into the circle. So, another thing I like to do before I insert now, we probably could give it a little more polys because it's kind of low poly right now. We want to get nice and smooth. So we're going to go to Turbo Smooth and we'll see. Not that much difference, so I'll stay like that. I'm not gonna collapse that down. And also, what I like to do is move the pivot point to the center. That way, we can always offset it and use it multiple times. So what you can do in Max is you hit Control and you right-click on the bottom down here, and you can set these all to zero. As you can see, that way you can move it around and make different areas. So we can use the same one twice, essentially. So, okay, so grab that, and we'll go to File, we'll go to Export Selected, Export Selected, and we'll go back to the folder. And I'll call this Skyrim. Or tendril. And when you're exporting out as an ASE from Max to Unreal, generally I just stay with the top two: mesh definition materials, geometry shapes, and mesh normals and mapping coordinates. Okay. And then I'm going to go back to Photoshop.